So I saw on your website you said painting is like a poem in color. It allows me to sing the beauty of my magic island, Haiti.
That's right.
I think that's so beautiful. So why do you think Haiti is a magic island?
Because Haiti is, people think Haiti is very mystical. But that yes, maybe some part is legend. But I know, as soon as you step in Haiti, I'm not talking Haiti, Haiti right now.
Yeah.
Because the politics take over. Haiti before, in the 40s, 50s, or stuti, or you hate it or you like it. But something that I know, when you go back to your country, you have to come back again. But you need more to discover. And then you go into here in the morning, you sleep on the beat of the drum, you wake up on the song of the rooster and the smell of the coffee.
You find your inspiration?
Mm-hmm. Yes, this is my environment. And then my reminiscence of Haiti. Well, I think like that. Each painting, they have something deep inside Haiti. Or the get hardship to live, you know, with people working hard to raise their family. You can see like I want a woman. This is all those things who makes in Haiti, who make Haiti a country, a one way you could see always in struggle.
Really powerful in the simplicity of some of the things you depict, and I think that's really beautiful.
That's right, that's it. I think the houses also, like
right.
You see, those typical old houses, the wooden houses, this one there, also, behind you. Well, I passed my childhood, almost my childhood, in this house. Since I was kid, about 4 years old, my father used to draw. I remember among his drawings is at the Jeremy Church. A church and atoms. Anytime he was going to open his desk, and then I went after him to let me see his drawing. Yes, let me see this drawing. And then from there, always, I was always drawing with whatever I could find.
That's amazing.
So many things happened also, remember. And then hurricane came, great house, everything. Disappear. Yes. After that, growing up, become at the age maybe of 10, my cousin used to be older than me. Mm-hmm. And he used to have what I call. He gave me a box of that. A few things left in the box of watercolor. Then where I'm going to find to find brush. No brush. And then Jeremy, what type of brush they sell? No, at this time. No, I have to get my own brush. I took chicken feathers. Chicken feathers, I washed them, and those two, three chicken fillets, I put some string on them, right there, and then how to get something, passing by water, and then, you know, two pence with six chicken fillets. Yes, not only me, but you have to do that.
That's great. I love that. Chicken pepper. Distributed everywhere, all over the world, and your website says that it's in the Rockefeller collection and the Onassis collection. What was your favorite exhibit?
Yes. My favorite exhibit is one that I had. That's two.
Okay.
I put the two most favorite exhibits. Yes. One I had in Haiti, but it was a trio exhibit. Me and then two other colleagues. Yes. It was fantastic. At the Nader residence. On top of the mountain. And then for this exhibit, he put some on by both sides of the road. They have some, they call it lampion. It's when you put kerosene and some little lamp with stick like that, and then form the main street going all the way to the gallery.
Mm-hmm.
It was fantastic. Yes. And then so many people at the thing. It was also my first contact with a large public.